morning, saints of God. How are you doing this morning? It's a glorious morning, Monday morning, the start of a new work weekend. Praise the Lord. What a great time we had in the house of God this week, and so many things are going on. Remember, later on this morning, I have a funeral service here for a young man that was killed, 26 years old, in a traffic accident. So just remember us here today. Pray that the Lord will give us liberty to preach the word of God and to give the gospel, to plan a salvation out to many today who will be here. But we thank God for all that he's doing. And boy, time is moving on, as we all can tell. And speaking about moving on, here we are. We're going through the book of Acts in our devotional study, just trying to get a devotional thought and not being so much preachy through the chapters, but just something to think about. And boy, we come to Acts chapter 13. What a powerful chapter. Paul and Barnabas, they hook up together. God calls them by his precious Holy Spirit. They go ahead and they lay hands on them, which reminds me, if you were in the services yesterday morning, you saw, or if you watched the services yesterday morning, you saw that we anointed and put hands on Justin to go out and preach the gospel. And he's a street preacher here in our church. I want to tell you something. That's the toughest job that God can call somebody to. I tell you, it's tough. And he's gone out preaching, and he just wants the church behind him, the church backing them with their prayer and their support. And symbolically, we laid our hands on him yesterday morning and anointed him with oil. Symbolically, there's no miracle in the oil. There's no miracle in the hands. The miracle power is in the message of the Lord Jesus Christ, that he loves us, that he died for sinners, that he rose again, and that he's willing to save sinners today. And we just pray that the Holy Spirit will fill Justin and be with him. But that's what's happening here in this chapter as well. Chapter 13, we find that Paul and Barnabas are sent out, and they go to different places through Asia Minor here, giving out the gospel different places. And they have a lot of people begin to follow them. The Jews get upset. There's persecution. And what a great sermon Paul preaches, completely about the Lord Jesus Christ, going back, talking about the Jews being there in Egypt, and then coming all the way through to the promised land, and just some good stories there if you go back and read it. Then he comes along here, and I want you to see what happens in verse 46. He goes and he preaches, and the Jews get upset, and they don't want the gospel preached. They're envious, and they don't want these things. They blaspheme God. And so Paul says this. It says in verse 46, "Then Paul and Barnabas waxed bold and said, it was necessary that the word of God should first have been spoken to you," speaking about the Jews, "but seeing ye put it from you and judge yourselves," look at these words, "unworthy of everlasting life." Wow. Paul said, you have found yourselves unworthy of everlasting life. Do you realize that today, every person who hears the gospel and rejects it is saying ultimately to God that I am unworthy of everlasting life. I'm unworthy of your gift. I'm unworthy of any concern, because I have no care, no love for you, no respect for you. And so they make themselves unworthy of everlasting life. He says, "Lo, we turn to the Gentiles." And if you go on down reading, you'll find out that the Gentiles were extremely glad of this, because they needed and wanted the message of salvation. Now, on a lot of different levels, we begin to look at this and we begin to realize that, man, the gospel now turns to the Gentiles. And we thank God for it, because you and I are the Gentiles. That's who we are. And thank God the glorious gospel message came to us. And, you know, yeah, it took years to get to us. Well, it took years for us to get here anyhow. But thank the Lord that it got to us. And thank the Lord that through his grace and through his power, we know Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. So Paul goes along preaching here, and it's a powerful thought. But I was just thinking about this thought devotionally. You know, they were missing out on the blessings of God. Just had a couple funerals, and, you know, ultimately in funerals, I end up saying something like, you know, salvation's not in church. And I believe that. I believe with all my heart, a person can go to heaven without going to church. But I'm going to tell you something. You know, once you get saved, you want to go and be part of church. You want the blessings of God. It's these folks here, they were missing the blessings of everlasting life. But I think so often, you and I as children of God miss the various blessings that God has for us just because, like these Jews, we thumb our nose up at God. Why? We don't think church is important, so we miss the value of church in our life. We don't think Bible reading is important, so we miss the value of knowing the love letter that God sent to us. We thumb our nose up, and sometimes we miss the value of what prayer is, and have that, how it develops a relationship and a worship time between us and the Lord. And so I was thinking so many different ways that, you know, we're just like them. We can snub our nose at the blessings that God has for us, and really we're the ones that get hurt. And just like these people, man, now their hurt is terrible. You think about this, the unworthy of everlasting life. That means for eternity they would be separated from Jesus Christ. And I'm just thinking in my mind, yeah, and that's true. But in the life of a lot of Christians who have life everlasting with the Lord Jesus Christ, they're still missing out on a lot of blessings that God has for them, all because they're too prideful, too arrogant, and unwilling to either obey Him or serve Him or trust Him like they should. And that speaks volumes to all of us in the different places in our life. And I just thought about that devotionally today, something for us to think about, because I want to tell you something. Life is too short to miss out on the blessings of God. God's got mighty and wonderful and precious blessings to you and I. And sometimes because of our arrogance and ignorance, we miss them. We skate around them because we feel like we know more than God. We feel like we're better than God. And that's exactly where they were. So we need to be careful of it. Just something for you to think about. Hey, when he says love and compassion, use love and compassion. There's a blessing that comes with that. When he says get rid of the bitterness, have forgiveness, there's a blessing that comes with that. When he says have mercy and pity, there's a blessing that comes with that. Listen, don't miss God's blessings on your journey. Pick them up. Use them. They're absolutely wonderful. Amen. All right, let's pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, we pray especially today for Brother Andy, who's having surgery, Father, and it's a very important surgery. He's been in so much pain. Father, we pray today, Lord, that you give the doctors wisdom. We pray, Lord, that you give Brother Andy a touch his body and protect him, Lord. And Father, we pray through this surgery, he'll be able to walk and do better. Father, be with Miss Marcia Campbell as well. Watch over and protect her. Father, Brother Bill, who's having to go into this hyperbaric chamber, Lord, we just pray that you'd be with him. Lord, for Jim West, Father, bless him and touch him. Lord, be with him. And Father, for these friends, we just pray you continue to use them. Father, use our lives. And Father, help us to be aware of the blessings that are daily around us. And Lord, help us to walk humbly. Help us to walk obediently, Father, that we may receive those great and precious handfuls on purpose that you have for us. For we pray in Jesus' name, amen. There you go. Go serve your King. Bye-bye.